We will discuss on random number and pseudo random numbers. Basically, when you will study different cryptographic algorithm mainly, you know, ciphers, we will find that they are using pseudo random numbers into them. The question is that why I have written random and pseudo random numbers. So what do you understand by random number or random event? Random means it is non-deterministic. That means what is going to happen, you can determine anyhow by any parameter before it happens, right? Now, our computer systems are totally deterministic because you have studied your computer organization operating systems and all these subjects. You have seen that every next step of a computer depends on the previous step, what happened. Or even automata theory you have studied, you have seen, right? So it only depends, the outcome only depends on the input provided to any process, right? Now, if you have a process which generate a random number, that process must start with some initial conditions, right? And as it starts with some initial condition and using some function, it is giving you some number as output, which we are going to call as random numbers. So it becomes a deterministic thing because that function is calculatable. If you know the mathematics of the function written inside, then you can calculate with the initial parameter what is the outcome you are going to have. Okay, but if you think a natural phenomenon or some natural signal like sound or some noise happening on the road, you can't determine that what will be the noise just after this, right? So it is totally random. So when we are working on computers, it is quite hard to generate a real random number on computer systems. Okay. And even if it is possible and using them for cryptographic algorithm becomes more, harder. So that is the reason we have to understand what is random number and what is pseudo random numbers and how to generate them to use them into different cipher. Now, use of random number, we can, in cryptography, generation of key for RSA. So later you will find, we will study asymmetric key encryption. There we will have a algorithm called RSA. And for RSA, we will find that we will need two prime number and which should be chosen randomly. So how we will generate these two prime numbers? You can generate random numbers, random primes, okay, and you can use for that. The key stream for one-time pad, like a different stream cipher we are going to study, you will find that in the stream cipher, you need one-time pad, which need to be randomly generated. Okay, so that one-time pad can be generated using some random number generator. Then initialization vector used in cipher. So in different cipher, you will find that we need to generate initialization vector, IV, randomly. So we will need random number there. Generation of stream key for symmetric key encryption. Like, so you are using some symmetric key encryption like, AES, DES, RC4, whatever. It may be your block cipher or stream cipher. So you will find there is use of random numbers. Then key distribution scenarios such as, Kerberos. So there is another problem we will find in our course that is called key distribution. So for how to distribute the key randomly, you will find. Okay, there also you will find there is use of random numbers. Then there is, based on their characteristic, how they are generated, we can divide them in mainly two for truly random number and pseudo random number. Truly random numbers, as I have already told, is what we understand in general by random. It defined as exhibits true randomness, such as the time between ticks from a ginger counter exposed to the radioactive element. That means you can't determine that how much TX ginger counter will be exposed to see the radioactive elements radiation. Okay, so this is a quite a complex example, but a simple example can be noise in the road, okay, or any other noise or any somebody speaking. You can't determine that what is going to speak. Only the person can determine that what he is going to speak, but other people can't do it. Okay, then should a random number is defined as having appearance of randomness. So when we look at a pseudo random number, it looks like random. Okay, exactly random. If you don't know that how it is generated, if you don't know the algorithm, but as you know, in cryptography, algorithms are public, so everybody will know the algorithm, right? So, but nevertheless, exhibits a specific repeatable pattern. So we'll find in a long sequence, if you analyze of a pseudo random number or random number generated by computer systems, you will find there is pattern actually. Okay, in a long length analysis, if you have few lakhs of bits, if you analyze, you will find there is repetition of pattern. That is problem. So that is another problem in cryptography and random number generation, that how to reduce this repeating patterns. Okay. The number calculated by computer through deterministic process cannot by definition be random. That is what I was telling. That if you are having deterministic process, like you have written a random number generation function, which takes some initial values to generate or start with, then it is a deterministic process. Then its output cannot be called as random numbers. Okay. So here you can see a random or pseudo number generator. There is three kind of generator shown here. First one you can see source of true randomness and conversion to binary and random bit stream. So it is going to give you true random number. So how it can be possible? Like you put a mic on the roadside, you record the noise, and you quantify that noise into bit stream. Okay. Then it will be a random bit stream, but it is not possible all the time. And cryptography, it will give you much trouble when you will use that kind of random numbers. Okay, because there is question of sender and receiver, how we will send this random number to the receiver so that he can use the same random numbers to decrypt the cipher text. Okay, so next comes deterministic algorithms, where you provide a seed value that is nothing but the initial parameters you are putting, and the deterministic algorithm is having some mathematics here, which gives the output as some pseudo random number or pseudo random bit stream. Okay, and usually these deterministic algorithms are iterative algorithms. Each iteration it produce one new random number or a set of random number. Okay, so this is another thing possible. Another kind of deterministic algorithm is there, where you have the seed, you have context specific values, and it's based on these two, the algorithm produce some random value, or we call pseudo random value, and it is again iterative. Now, what is this context specific value? Numbers of time you will find we are taking the timestamp in consideration. Okay. Or say if it is in case of healthcare, it can be some electrocardiogram rate or some other patient specific value, which is quite different to patient to patient. Okay, or it can be say some value generated from your biometric as an input to generate a random number. Okay, so that can happen in the third case. Requirements, I mean, I have already told, so what are the requirements to select a random number, to choose a random number or a random number generator? Based on what parameters we can choose? First thing is that it should be statistically random. That means if you just statistically analyze, you should not get any pattern, you should not get any other values are there. You will find there is many values defined in NIST NIST random number tests to it. Okay, so all these values are comes under statistical test, and you can find them. Then the number should be uniform, should be of uniform distribution. That means number of zeros and number of ones in the distribution should be quite same. And independent, that means it should not much dependent on the previous sequence, so that you know, if you are looking at the previous sequence, you should not be able to you know, understand what should be the next number generated by the function. Okay, see, if you know the function or if you know the algorithm and initial values, definitely you can generate the whole sequence. Okay, so that sequence may be of any length, 1 lakh numbers can be there. Okay, but as you know, in cryptography, the algorithm is public, but the key, the seed, the initial vector is not public. That is secret for you. Okay, now, so one attacker having the algorithm, okay, or one attacker is just recording what numbers is generated, or the random number sequence generated by your algorithm, but he does not know what is your secret key or seed or the initial vector. Okay, but by analyzing your output sequence, after some time, it should not be possible to guess what should be the next random number generated by your algorithm. Okay, so that is what is called independent. Another is unpredictability. So it should not be predictable that again what kind of number you are going to generate and what sequence it is going to generate forward. Okay, so that is called what? Unpredictability. Okay, now PRNG requirements, that means pseudo random number generator, PRNG, pseudo random number generators requirement. So how to choose, you know, or when you say that certain PRNG is useful. So first one is again uniformity. I have already told you, at any point in the generation of PRN, the pseudo random number sequence, the occurrence of zeros or ones is equally likely. That means probability of occurring a zero, probability of occurring a one should be half or 0.5. Okay, then scalability. Any test for randomness applicable to the sequence can also be applicable to the random sequence. That means there is, I have already told you, different tests are there to test random randomness of sequence. The same test should be applicable, and the PRNG should generate such sequence that the sequence should pass all the test of randomness test. Okay. Then consistency. The characteristic of pseudo random number sequence of the PRNG or pseudo random number generator must not depend on the seed used. Okay, that is what called consistency. That means you know, what seed you have used, that should not be predictable by looking. You understand? Say you have an algorithm. I also know the algorithm. And you have used some secret seed or initial value to generate a sequence of random number. Now you have given that sequence of random number to me. Now I am analyzing that by doing some reverse engineering, that what should be the key used by you so that this algorithm generated these numbers. Okay, that can be there. So that thing should not be there. Then another generator, example of generator called linear congruential generator, linear congruential generator. So what it does, it generates some random or pseudo random numbers. Okay, so it is a very common iterative technique used in it. You can see x n plus 1 equal to ax plus c mod n. So this mod n is used so that you know the generated number should have a scale from 0 to this m, say m is 100 or say 512. So all the generated number should not exceed 512. Okay, so that is the thing. So you can understand. So here initial value you have to provide for A, you have to provide an initial value for x0 and C. Okay, and M is a constant, so say it is 100 if you give, then if you calculate, you know, A x n plus C and then mod M, what value you will get, that will be the value of generated random number x n plus 1. Again, if you put x n plus 1 here, x n plus 2 value you can calculate and so on. If you put it in a for loop, it will keep generating random number. Okay. Now, given suitable values of parameter can produce a long random-like sequence, then suitable criteria to have is function generates a full period. That means, you know, there should not be a repetition of period. Okay. Then period means here the repetition of same sequence. Okay, so first 10 numbers and next 10 numbers are going to be same. The sequence, I mean, okay, sequence of first 10 numbers, sequence of next 10 numbers generated. If it is same, then we will say that this generator is having a period of 10. Okay, usually, you know, a good random number generator may have period of in term of lakhs or crores. Okay. But if you have, if you don't have a good random number generator, then you will, you may have a very, you know, short period. So that what will happen after some time, it will start generating same sequence of number. Then generated sequence should appear random. That means what sequence it is generating, it should appear random. It should not be, you know, it should not be a sequence, you know, arithmetic sequence. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it is generating. Now that is not going to be treated as random number. It should be, you know, mix up properly, okay? And distributed over, you know, the space properly. Then efficient implementation with 32-bit arithmetic. So basically, still the date, why this problem? That many programming languages was supporting only 32-bit arithmetic. So we was only considering the algorithms which will have, you know, which will be able to implement in 32-bit processor and such a language like even C was, you know, in had C also had the same constraint. Okay, but if you are using some other programming language, this becomes a little bit less important to be implementable in 32-bit arithmetic. Definitely, because you know the arithmetic operations are going to be unlimited number of bits. Okay. Not that an attacker can reconstruct sequence given a small sequence. This is, you know, from attacker side, what I was telling you that a small number of values generated by your algorithm, as I have recorded. And after that, what values you are going to generate using your algorithm, that as an attacker, if I can guess, okay, then that is a bad thing. Okay, then it happens in this linear concurrential generator, then have possibilities for making this harder, but there is possibilities are there. We can make this guess harder. Understand? So this is a generator. You can write a for loop. In a for loop, you can put this code and you can generate random numbers. Okay, by setting up, by give the initial values of A, C, X0, and M is definitely the space in which you want to generate your random numbers. Okay. Then another generator is there, which is called Blum-Blumstroth generator. So it is based on public key algorithms. Generate least significant bit from the iterative sequence. So what is the iterative sequence given here is xi equal to xi minus 1 square mod n, where n is p into q and p q should be 3 mod p and q should be prime and they should be 3 mod 4. Okay, so p and q are prime and n is p into q basically. Okay, And you put some initial value of x0 so that you can generate in a for loop, you can generate value of x1. And again, you put use x1 value at place of x I minus 1, and it will give you x2 value. Okay, so you can understand. So what are the properties are there? It is unpredictable, passes next bit test, that is the next bit test algorithm and test is there, it passed the test. Then security resist on the difficulty of factoring n. So here is a problem of factorization of n. Okay, so if n is given, n is the space in which you want to generate the random numbers, saying then it is going to be 0 to 100 number space, then in that case you have to find out two prime numbers p and q by factoring n. Okay, so that is a challenge here. And then it is unpredictable given by run of bits. So any run of bits, that means you take any sequence of bit with any length. Okay, so it is unpredictable. Okay, so that means it doesn't matter how long sequence of bits you are providing to the attacker. Attacker will not be able to predict what is your x0 value, what is your p and q. Okay, then it is slow since very large numbers must be used, because this x square is going to be every time a large number, one thing, and every n should be also quite big, otherwise the choice for choosing p and q will be quite small space. Okay, because if n is 100, how many prime numbers is there below 100? Okay, so that out of those prime numbers, how many pairs will be there which will satisfy the given condition? Okay, so that is problem. Then too slow for cipher use, good for key generation. So this BlumBlum sub generator suitable for using in cipher, but it can be used for key generation, because the key generation we don't do frequently, a few times we do during our communication. So it can be used for key generation. So as a assignment, you can just implement all these random number generators in Python. Okay. Then using block cipher as PRNG, next, we have not discussed even one of the block cipher yet, but when we will discuss just after a few days, you will understand that the block ciphers can be generated and it can be used as generator of random numbers. Okay, so I'm not discussing this much right now. Okay, then here is another ANSI, that is standard ANSI X9.17 PRG, the pseudo random number generator. Okay, which looks like this. DTI is the date and time, so it takes date and time as a what is called the context parameter. Yes, it takes a context parameter. VI is the initial parameter, some initial value you can give. Okay, and you can give two key here, key1 and key2. Okay, then it draws this